We're in Two Rivers, just north of Manitowoc, Wisconsin, on Lake Michigan. We did some whitefish fishing, got to meet all the fishermen, see what a day in the life is like for them. For me, it was really interesting to just see the work, see the connection that they have with the lake, and make that connection with our restaurant. My name is Derek Lee. I'm with Pizza Brutta in Madison, Wisconsin.
Hi, I'm Patrick McCormick, Mahler's Public House, Madison, Wisconsin.
Adam Struebing, the Madison Club, Madison, Wisconsin.
It was cool to see the scale of what this is, and also like the perspective of pulling several hundred pounds of fish out of the water at one time. So the amount of work that you see that goes into it on ground zero, then an additional amount of work to put something on a plate is it's pretty crazy, start to finish, the amount of work that goes into one piece of fish.
As the deck goes out, now we gotta change these cables, hook it up to the doors. The doors go down to the bottom, spread the net out, and we drag it for 45 minutes. The opposite, hook it back up, wind it up.
My name's Paul LeClair. Me and my brother are the owners of Susie Q Fish Company in Two Rivers, Wisconsin, right on Lake Michigan. We are kind of on a point, so we are like 6 miles out in the lake. We have 4 commercial fishing boats, which we use. We started out commercial fishing, and then we decided to start smoking some of our own fish that we're catching. Commercial fishing is kind of slowing down, so we had to diversify a little bit, and then we got into the smoke fish, which kind of is a little bit more than what commercial fishing is now. Whitefish, salmon, which we purchased from Alaska, and there's some lake trout.
My name is Titus Seilheimer. I'm a fisheries specialist with Wisconsin Sea Grant. We got up early and headed out on Lake Michigan. We were catching lake whitefish in the commercial trawling boat. I've been partnering with Susie Q on a multi-year study looking at bycatch associated with whitefish trawling. What I was doing, I'm sort of the science eye in this study. So I am keeping an eye on what the bycatch is, what species we're catching, and seeing what happens to those when we release them back into the lake, because those are fish that we're not keeping.
It was like 550 pounds of whitefish on this side. One lake trout.
One of the things we like to do is feel a part of something, and this brought me closer to fishing here in Wisconsin, and I feel like I understand it better and have a better connection to this fishery than I did before today.
My great-grandfather came over in the late 1800s from Canada. Some of the family decided to be farmers and some decided to be fishermen. Well, my grandfather, Joe, decided he wanted to be a fisherman. I've been doing it, since I was 12. As probably a little younger than that, I would go with my two brothers and my dad. We do have the captains, which came from another fishing family. They ended up selling their boats, so we got two of the Copas, Jeremy Copa and John Copa. Their dads are both fishermen. They work for us. It's kind of a small knit group. We don't have a lot of people, but you know, it's 5-6 people, and you have to be able to do all kinds of different things.
Opened my eye to like preserving like our heritage almost in this area. It was like we're supporting these like families that have been doing this for generations, and it's just really cool like to tie it all together and, you know, support them, give people a good product. Like, it's just like an all around good thing. But
I definitely seek out things that are labeled local and Great Lakes fisheries. You don't realize how great the fish is right by you because you're able to buy something that's from far away. Except for the local whitefish is way more fresh and way more tasty, and yeah, if you actually try it, you can tell.
I think also with sourcing, you know, organic vegetables and locally grown meats, a lot of times the farmers are coming to your back door, whereas, you know, the fishermen aren't typically coming to your back door. So through Sea to Table, you know, we're able to essentially have that relationship where that seafood or that, you know, is coming to our back door.
Is super important, and I find a good value in that.